If you are new to my channel and want to educate yourself more about herpes viruses, please like my videos and subscribe to my channel. Make sure to ring on the notification bell so that you'll be the first to watch my uploaded videos every day. Let's put an end to the herpes virus. Signs and symptoms of herpes 2. The symptoms of herpes generally occur in two waves: an initial outbreak, which occurs after the virus incubates in the body, and subsequent outbreaks. Initial herpes outbreaks typically involve an itching and burning around the genitals, in the case of genital herpes, or around the mouth, in the case of oral herpes. Within a day or so, blisters can form in the affected area and develop into open, fluid-filled sores. During an initial herpes outbreak, it's common to experience headaches, muscle pains, fatigue, and other flu-like symptoms. Many people also experience pain while urinating. Recurring herpes outbreaks are similar, but are usually less severe than the initial outbreak. In people with HSV2, outbreaks can occur up to 5 times a year, requiring 2 to 3 weeks to pass. People with HSV1 typically experience 1 to 2 outbreaks per year, but that frequently varies drastically person to person. How to check if you have asymptomatic herpes 2? If you have no herpes symptoms but believe you might have been exposed to the virus, you can take a herpes test to verify whether or not you're infected. The most accurate herpes testing method for asymptomatic people is an IgG test, which checks for the presence of IgG antibodies in your blood. These antibodies can signal a herpes infection. Using certain testing methods, they can also be used to differentiate between HSV1 and HSV2. IgG antibodies can take several months to form after a herpes infection, meaning you'll typically need to wait for 12 to 16 weeks before taking an IgG test to make sure you receive an accurate result. If you're concerned that you might have asymptomatic herpes, the best approach is to speak to your doctor about testing options. Your doctor will be able to schedule a test based on the date of your potential exposure to the virus and provide you with an accurate diagnosis. If you discover you do have HSV1 or HSV2, the most important thing is to not panic. These viruses are extremely common, and there are a variety of antiviral medications out there to help minimize the severity and frequency of outbreaks. Most notably, valacyclovir. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel for my upcoming herpes treatment videos.